Hi, I'm the Rap Critic. Let's talk about Christmas rap songs. There aren't any.
Boy, was I wrong. I mean, I knew there were a few Christmas-themed rap songs, but not enough to compile a whole list, let alone two. But yeah, there's a whole genre of these things I missed, and I'd like to share some of them with you. So let's get started with the worst. Number 6. So, fun fact, Ying Yang Twins made a Christmas rap album. Yes, the guys responsible for about 80% of strip club songs between 2001 and 2004 want to tell you about Christmas. And at first, it's kind of interesting to hear the hemiola of the Carol of the Bells motif. But then you realize most of the song is exactly what they always talk about. And it's not like they're using any wordplay about being in a strip club at Christmas or anything like that. It's just, we're at a strip club again. Oh yeah, and Christmas. But I guess the world is better off not hearing stuff like, I don't know, till the sweat drips from my bells or something. It's Christmas night, time to hit the club. Oh yes, you're only hitting up the strip club because it's Christmas. I mean, as we all know, Ying Yang Twins only go to strip clubs on special occasions. Hey, it's Christmas! Time to go to the strip club! Hey, it's close enough to my birthday! Time to go to the strip club! Hey, it's a day ending in Y! Time to go to a strip club! It isn't until the third verse where they actually start talking about Christmas-related stuff. But then you get to the chorus, and... What the hell is that? It sounds like an evil drunk homeless guy belching through a holiday greeting. You can almost smell the halitosis. Seriously, this chorus sounds, like, menacing. It's saying Merry Christmas, but it sounds less like well-wishing and more like he's putting a curse on you. I just hope their other Christmas-themed strip club songs sound better than this. Okay, that's a little funny. Number 5. So, fun fact, Insane Clown Posse made a Christmas album. And I'm sure you guys remember me talking about this song in the Insane Clown Posse episodes me and Diamanda Hagen did. But suffice to say, despite how much I can appreciate that the song is taking down mainstream culture's assimilation of Santa Claus for a holiday that highlights the conditions of poor kids by pushing the idea of buying and having lots of presents, which of course poor parents can't afford, which once again I think can be aptly summed up in this clip.
Don't go that way, Rudolph. That's the ghetto. Those boys and girls, they don't deserve anything.
Still, it's an Insane Clown Posse song, so most of it has to be filled with killing someone, namely Santa Claus. I'm that sniper on the building! Listen to my nine go click! And yeah, having a song about killing a mythological person, that's kinda stupid. Especially since they seem to want to just, in general, kill anyone dressed as Santa. Santa Claus, suck my balls! Drunk ass hell, ringing bells at the malls! Like, you know the Salvation Army guy's not actually Santa, right? I get that you're angry and stuff, but, you know, pull up on the CEO meetings at Macy's or something. Don't shoot the people doing charity work, for God's sakes. Especially if the point of your song is that people don't give to the poor enough. Some say I was bad, but that wasn't it. It's all because Santa was a fat bitch. Are you sure it's not because you were a bad kid? I mean, you're calling Santa a fat bitch. It's not exactly something that a nice kid would say. And actually, in the song, that you've shown that you've been a bad kid. I'm just saying, in this case, if you're not getting presents, that one might be on you. Me, I got a little half, little chunk of dog shit. Who the hell gave you a chunk of dog shit? Unless it's just coal and you don't know what it looks like, because, I mean, coal isn't exactly a household item anymore. See, you did get something, but it was coal, because you were a little bastard this year. Next year, don't be good just for the presents, you little Cartman. Don't you know the song? Be good for the sake of goodness, man.
Number 4.
Yeah, I know people don't usually include the song they use in the bumpers for the countdown, but I'm sure at this juncture I don't have to point out the most glaringly bad part of this song, right? But the funny thing is, right after this horrible, silly chorus, we actually get a really good beat and some serious lyrics about what Christmas is like in the hood. Now it's Christmas Eve and I'm like behind bars, sitting in a cell, looking up at the stars, reminiscing about my kids with tears in my eyes, cause you black and your poke is pale, you only hear gunshots, you never hear bells. But even with these verses, which content-wise are pretty engaging, the stilted delivery and flow kinda cuts away some of the emotion. Thinking to myself, I just wanna die. That sentence was said just a little too buoyantly. Like, I'm thinking to myself, I just want to die. All throughout the song, there are just tonal problems that make it hard to take it seriously, even though that seems to be the point.
Because when I look, I see reflections of me. Kids in the ghetto, never had a Christmas tree. No Christmas cards, just a letter sent a rent late.
Yeah, listen to the pain and realities of black men who feel helpless against the perpetuation of the struggle in their neighborhoods.
My little brother wanted a bike, he got skates.
Yeah, actually, skates aren't that bad. I mean, they're not bikes, but, you know, it's alright for a kid. And then, after all these lines that are okay but falter because, I mean, it's Master P, he's not exactly a great rapper in the first place, we then get this part.
All you broke motherfucking rappers out there making all these tapes and selling all these tapes. You broke, bitch. You can't buy a goddamn thing this Christmas because you been sold out, you cunt.
This seems unnecessary.
Yo, man, hold up. What about the 3 days of Christmas?
Oh, okay.
Oh, please, no.
On the first day of Christmas, a dope fiend brought to me
a TV and a bitch from up the street.
Make it stop.
On the second day of Christmas, a dope fiend brought to me
two VCRs and a TV and a bitch.
Number 3. So, fun fact, Afro Man made a Christmas album. Nah, I'm just kidding. He actually made 2. But if you look at the track listing of Occult 45 Christmas and Joe Baybells, a title that I have literally no idea what it's supposed to mean, really, I couldn't find any connotation that would make sense on an album like this, so if anyone knows, you know, hit me up. They seem to include a lot of the exact same songs. Now, I know Christmas albums are usually made on the cheap, so you can rest them out quick, but did they just think no one would notice? Other than the general population of Earth that seemed to forget about Afro Man after Because I Got High. But anyways, so how does the irreverent rascal Afro Man devilishly twist the classic Frosty the Snowman song into a new parody?
Frosty the Snowman had a dick of snow.
Okay.
He could only fuck a bitch if her pussy was real cold.
So he's never able to have sex?
Frosty tried to fuck this gun, ain't that, but her pussy was too high.
This is not really funny.
He tried to fuck a queer.
Whoa!
The sun would appear and Frosty had to run.
What the f, man?
Now it's time for Frosty's dick to disappear.
Say what?
He'll say goodbye, but don't you cry. He'll fuck you again next year.
Okay, I know it's supposed to be a joke song, but there's supposed to be, like, a joke. I mean, his dick melts and he's bisexual. Ha ha ha. Really scraping the bottom of the barrel for these jokes here. Let's move on. Number 2. Okay, first off, police blow my wad? What the hell is that supposed to mean? Does looking at police officers make you ejaculate? I don't know what else I'm supposed to get from that. And secondly, talk about aiming low for a song to parody. There's only like 4 lines in it. So what does he say at the end of the 3 repetitions?
Police blow my wad. Police blow my wad.
He just repeats it again? So what about the Porteos Baños Felicidad part? For God's sakes, there's only 4 lines in the whole song. You couldn't be bothered to write something that rhymed with the first part? Well, I guess if you're starting a song with some nonsensical phrase like police blow my wad, yeah, you were never really going anywhere in the first place. Seriously, what the hell else is police blow my wad supposed to mean other than the idea that he gets off when looking at cops?
I wish the cops would stop fucking with us. I wish the cops would stop fucking with us.
Oh, okay, so the first part he's talking to the police like, hey, police, why don't you go blow my wad? That's not really a thing that people say, especially not when they're angry. So it just sounds like an awkward phrase that doesn't make any sense. And I know I put Afro Man on here twice, but damn, these songs are really the worst that album had to offer. It's just the most base, unfunny premises. Premises? That I'm not sure would get a laugh out of anyone but himself. Not saying we should expect genius rhymes from a guy who's most famous for a song about smoking so much weed he ruined his life through sheer laziness, but at least that song amped it up. You see his life get worse and worse because of his habit, and that's what's funny about it. These songs just get stuck in one place and go nowhere. Well, we had a lot of fun with this list. Actually, I had no fun at all, it was horrible. But before we get to number 1, let's look at some dishonorable mentions. The rest of this Afro Man album, it really is f***ing horrible.
Please,
number 1. So this song is just a clusterfuck. I don't need to hear Eazy-E having an orgasm. That's just the middle of it though. It starts off kinda promising with the actor who played Dolomite telling a story to a little girl. So you know, keep that in mind while you're listening to this.
He was drinking whiskey and gin at the age of 3. Listen and listen well. He's a bad motherfucker.
Give me that goddamn book. Here, let me read you this one.
But then, thank God, the mother snatches the book from him and...
It was a silent night. Yes, a holy night. Until Mr. Claus turned into Santa motherfucking, right?
Still reads a story about Eazy-E, so... I'm not sure how this is gonna be better. Like, she says Easy Claws really confused, like she doesn't know what's happening, but by the harp transition music that plays, I'm assuming she's still going on to read it. Okay, so the story goes that Santa Claus turns into Eazy-E, because... why the f*** not? And we find out about his many adventures. Hey, the parent knows that she can put down this book at any point, right?
Come sit on my face, I mean left.
Okay, that was funny. We then hear some raps from a female group literally named Ménage à Trois. Yeah, and you thought Nicki Minaj was the only female rapper who used her namesake as a reference to a threesome. Ha ha ha. Look, I understand they're being crass on purpose, and I get that that's the point, but you know, doesn't mean I have to enjoy it. No, you don't. You do not want to have sex in the snow. Literally, no one wants to do that. What? Don't sit on the roof, cough up Rudolph's nuts. I got nothing. I have no idea what the hell that's supposed to mean. The song then devolves into a smorgasbord of horrible ghetto parodies of Christmas songs.
My homeboys gave to me 3 pounds of endo, 2 pounds of cocaine, and an A motherfucking gay. Bitch.
I love mommy fucking Eazy Claws.
Close the door, little bitch, I'm getting these draws.
I'ma tell my daddy.
I have absolutely no commentary that I could add that can top how bad this is on its own. Except to further bewilder you by letting you know that just when you think this song can't get any stranger, it includes guest verses from the Black Eyed Peas.
Yo, Black, you don't want for Christmas.
Yo, Black, I want a job.
Oh, oh, oh.
Get out my fucking yard with your carol.
Yo, I could get busy and climbing like a...
That's right. When they were in a group called the At-Band Clan, Will.i.am and Apple D-App, possibly two of the most un-gangster rap West Coast MCs, were on a Christmas song with Eazy-E. I don't even know what reality is anymore.
I am on a rhymer. I'm done with the At-Band Clan. We're making a shit. I'm slamming. It's Christmas time.
The simple sound of Christmas make me jump, jump, jump.
I'm delete them, I'm delete them, I'm delete them.
Well, at least there's one constant element in this world we can depend on, and that's this. Yes, Black Eyed Peas were always this mediocre.
Merry motherfucking Christmas. Merry motherfucking Christmas. Merry motherfucking Christmas. And have a fucked up New Year.